As you probably know, the big dream of Elon Musk is setting up a colony on Mars. The thing that you might not know is the fact that colonization of Mars is an extremely hard challenge. To make the whole venture a bit easier, SpaceX is developing their new rocket Starship, which will be able to transport people to the Red Planet. Unfortunately, even if SpaceX team used Starship, the journey to Mars will still last at least 7 months. The idea, which can significantly reduce the journey time, is the nuclear propulsion system of a Starship. But is it even possible to build a nuclear-powered Starship? And what does Elon Musk think about it? About this and much more in today's video. During his press releases, Musk relayed his vision for humanity. He said that there are only two ways forward in history. One of them is that we become a space-faring civilization and colonize other planets like Mars. And the other is that we never move towards safe travel and lose the whole of humanity at an extinction-level event. With increasing level of climate degradation, an extinction-level event doesn't look far. Already, global temperatures are rising and natural calamities are increasing in number and intensity. So to carry out Musk's vision, SpaceX started working on starships that could take humanity to the nearest planet, that is, Mars. The problem with this is that even though the Red Planet is in the neighborhood, it still takes around 9 months for a one-way journey. Added to that, only 100 passengers can go at a time. This means that to get a sustainable human settlement started would take decades. Not to mention the problems associated with the space travel. One of these issues is solar radiation, which rightly decreases the lifespan of the affected party, and on top of that, can cause sterility, which will mean that the human settlement on Mars might never flourish. The timeline isn't sustainable, and the one thing that can reduce it substantially is using nuclear power. The thing about nuclear power is that it's 400 times more powerful than the traditional chemical power used. You would need a far smaller supply of uranium than hydrazine to power these rockets. A reduced time period would mean that the exposure to solar radiation would drastically be reduced, meaning a healthier set of humans would arrive at Mars. More importantly, it means that the time it is taken to and back from Mars will be less, which would make it far easier to set up a sustainable and efficient community on the planet. Rumors are that SpaceX has started work on developing a nuclear propulsion system. Musk has even said that using nuclear power would be far more efficient than the traditional chemical power in the Raptor engine. You will be surprised to know that this isn't the first time humanity has thought of using nuclear power. Ever since the 50s, humans have considered building a nuclear-powered spacecraft. In fact, the idea of the first nuclear-powered spacecraft came in 1940 when Robert A. Heinlein, a naval engineer and a science fiction writer, wrote about a spacecraft propelled by a nuclear explosion in a short story. After the Second World War, the Polish scientist Stanislaw Ulam and American physicist Frederick Rhines made preliminary calculations that outlined how the rocket would be powered by nuclear power. Sadly, no one took these calculations seriously until 10 years later in 1958, when the Orion project began, the actual project which focused on developing a nuclear-powered spacecraft was led by Ted Taylor of General Atomics and physicist Freeman Dyson, who'd taken a year off from his studies at Princeton. The main idea behind the Orion was that it would be a spacecraft that would offer high thrust and a high specific impulse of propellant efficiency. However, this had a lot of energy requirements. These requirements would be met by nuclear power. But since containing the blast inside the rocket would be too dangerous, this was decided that the blast would place entirely outside the rocket. One would consider why such extreme steps were being taken. The reason was that no other propulsion system could deliver the same level of energy. Chemical rockets could provide high thrust with very low specific impulses, while batteries could only provide small thrusts. Sadly, Project Orion wasn't successful. If, however, the scientists had somehow managed to contain nuclear energy, the Orion would have been the most powerful rocket at the time. In 1963, the Partial Test Ban Treaty ended the project officially, and no substantial research was allowed in the field. Many scientists also believe that there were other problems with Project Orion. One of those was the consistent nuclear explosions would erode the outer layer of the rocket, which would prove extremely dangerous for the people inside. So do you guys think that we will be able to see another project, or even taking place in the recent age? Well, the chances of that happening are increasingly daily. Technology since the 60s has seen an exponential level of development. Using nuclear energy is no longer as much of an issue as it was back then. Well, if anyone is going to do it, it will be SpaceX. Musk is known for embracing innovation and adopting technologies that will increase efficiency. According to scientists, there are currently two ways to approach a nuclear-powered starship. One of those is nuclear thermal propulsion. In this method, a nuclear reactor, like the one used in nuclear-powered submarines, will be fitted into the rocket. This reactor will function like it usually does, and the heat generated from its reactions will be used to heat a gas, for example, hydrogen. The heated gas will be pushed through a nozzle at the end, which will give the rocket energy to move forward. This method is twice as efficient as the traditional chemical approach. To give you an idea of the kind of energy we are talking about, imagine a car fitted with a nuclear reactor as an engine. This car will be able to reach speeds of 0 to 60 miles per hour in a quarter of a second. Though a car would survive the process, yes, the energy produced is huge. Basically, the travel time will be reduced by 25%. The second approach is nuclear electric propulsion. This method works on the process of producing electricity using nuclear fission. Yes, breaking down the nuclear particles and then using the energy produced from splitting the atoms. The electricity produced would then be used to power the rocket. This method is 3 times more efficient than the one mentioned earlier. You won't need any sort of solar energy, and the thrusts produced by the rocket will be substantial. The energy produced would be so great that the travel time would actually be reduced by 75%. That means if you reached in 9 months, you would be able to arrive at your destination in around 3 to 4 months. The thing about SpaceX rocket is that in addition to the supposed development of new powerful engines, the company is working on safety and reusability. For example, they are working on shielding panels to protect passengers from solar radiation. In addition, the rockets are being designed in such a way that they can be reused multiple times. Another step in the right direction is the new LiDAR fuselage, and fuel is being developed. Nuclear is supposedly only going to be used in space until the rocket clears the Earth's atmosphere. It will rely on traditional chemical rockets, after which the nuclear mechanism will take over. In our opinion, and from what we have seen Musk doing the last few years, there are increasing chances that you will hear about a nuclear propulsion system in the near future. If you want more specific answers, then we believe that Elon Musk will go for the nuclear electric propulsion. Now, obviously, there are challenges when nuclear energy comes into the picture, but Musk doesn't look like a man who runs from challenges. Only time will truly tell what the scientist at SpaceX has in store for the world. These were our reflections on the nuclear Starship concept. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a thumbs up.